Hello there lovely folks, this is Ajita. Welcome back to my channel. So today we have a video wherein we'll be learning using some of the basic nozzles. This is part 1 of it. I'll be uploading part 2 very shortly. So let's get started with it now. Please like, share, subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon below to get a notification. So before jumping in the video, I'm giving you a quick tip. Here is my star tip. So I only have one star tip. I will use only one for different colors. How do? I put my star tip in a piping bag like this. So now next time when I am having a color, I use it a different piping bag and I pop that into the piping bag wherein I put my star tip. So this way I don't have to use different tips or clean my piping bag every time I use it. So this is how I manage using different colors using a single tip. Let's get started with the star tip now. First, I'll show you cupcake tops. First and foremost, the perfect rosette, something every baker should know. First, just hold your piping bag exactly perpendicular to your cupcake. Then start piping at the center. Give it a gentle squeeze. Now start moving your piping bag in a circle. Now, as soon as you're almost about to end it, stop the pressure and pull it away so that it gives you a perfect rosette. See that? That's how you do it. Now coming to the swirl top. This is widely used topping for cupcakes generally. We start at the edge instead of the center. Now we move in circle and now we overlap while moving in circle so that we make at least two rounds and then just give it a wiggle and move it out. So that's how you make a swirl topping. Now coming to top drops, you hold your piping bag perpendicular to your cupcake, exactly perpendicular. Now you press and lift, place it over little higher, press and lift. You don't lift your piping bag while you're still pressing because it gives an odd oblong shape to the drop. See the stars, they look almost like stars on your cupcake. This can be used for hydrangeas, flowers, etc. Now the chain piping, you place your piping bag perpendicular, press, then move back and release, then press, move back and release. You have to press it while you're holding it still and then move it a little. So that's how you use chain piping. Now coming to different techniques we can use for the cake walls. First I'll be showing a straight edge miniature ruffles. So the star tip, when you're using star tip in straight lines across the wall of the cake, it almost makes it look like they are tiny ruffles. So see, can you see that? So you just press and go in straight line across the cake. You repeat until you get your number of ruffles and you complete the side walls of the cake. Check it out. Next is rosettes. So when you're doing rosettes, start little higher from the cake bottom and swirl like you have already done for the cupcake, but pull it out a little out of the circle so that next time when you're starting, you will start where you have pulled out exactly. So you press, move it in circular direction. Once you're almost about to reach the edge, pull it out a little. And you repeat to make every rosette for the side of the wall. Doing this assures that all your rosettes are overlapped and there is no gap between those. So when you're starting second line, you start at the gaps between the rosettes of the first line, not parallel to those, so that there won't be any gaps. Next comes the Bella ruffles, as I call them in my class. These are almost the curves you can pipe with your star tip. They almost look like the dress the Bella wears in Beauty and the Beast, so I call them those. So here you can see I'm just making small U's around the cake and I repeat the same for all the lines, and I repeat the same to cover all the cake with them. Next we'll be seeing how to weave. This will be moving in almost S shapes. You press, lift it a little and move it down and lift up. This will be good for cakes which you want to portray a knitting pattern with your star tip. See, it almost looks like you have waved it. Next, the chain piping. Like we have done for the cupcakes, we press there so that it gives a little bulge and pull it out. We repeat the same to form a chain kind of a pattern. And this must take a little time, but be a little patient because the outcome is beautiful. So now the modified rosette. This is absolutely beautiful for sea themed cakes, wherein you want almost like a wave kind of a pattern. I use ombre blue to get this effect. As you can see, it almost looks like a sea tide. Now coming to zigzags, as easy as it sounds, just go up and down with your star piping nozzle. You'll get your zigzag pattern. Now coming to heart wave. All you have to do is give the same action of hand as in chain piping, but just cross each thing so that you get your heart shape. This is your simple drop tips. This, your imagination is the limit. You can use different colors, different shapes to pipe. There are many more piping patterns which you can do with your star tip, but for today I think I've covered almost all the basic piping techniques one needs to know to start off with their cakes. So thanks for watching, guys. This is Ajita signing off. Love you all. We'll be back soon with more videos.